Something big coming up on your screen. Just settle back and relax, cause you're gonna get a whole lot of singing, a whole lot of laughing, a whole lot of loving from me.
Ain't nobody cleaned it in a week, I imagine. Oh, well, I feel great tonight anyhow. You know, I came home from a... Gosh, dog it. I came home... I look like I've been printed again from the files. Did that to me in Ohio once. Oh, I came home today, you know, from Pebble Beach, the golf tournament. The end is before the end. Tournament. You gonna go? Yeah, I was gone 8 days, and I walked into my house, and, you know, Jeannie missed me. Then she raised the revolver again. This just wasn't my day. At breakfast, I found out that my kid, Dino, joined one of those motorcycle surfing clubs. He stands on the seat as he drives through the car wash. I bawled him out that he threatened to leave home. And I threatened to leave the door open. You know something? I figured out having kids is hereditary. Which ain't a bad word. They're hereditary. You didn't think I know what that meant. For the benefit of you folks who never flew in one. Anyway, having kids is hereditary. Yeah, if your folks didn't have any, chances are you won't. Dirty Paul. And now, Jeannie gave me that joke. And now, Jeannie's given me a lot of jokes since we've been married. But that's the first one she didn't have to go to the hospital for. Now, don't you go away, because I'm going to wash up.
Let me tell you a little story about Hans. I was on the show about 6-8 months or so, and I just finished showing Dean a sketch, and I went back into the dressing room to say, come on, let's go out and do it, pal. And I called him pal, he called me pal. And he was sitting on the couch, I reached down to help him up, and my hands were like this, and his hands were like this, and they grabbed, it looked like two lobster claws, you know. And he looked at my hands, and he said, what's the matter with your hands? And I went, well, you know, when I was in high school, I played guard on the football team, and, you know, I didn't wrap my fingers, and, you know, they stepped on my fingers, and they're all busted and broken up. And I looked at his hands, and I said, and you? He said, well, you know, he said, I was a semi-pro fighter. And he said, I must have been as dumb as you were, because I didn't wrap my knuckles, and they're all busted. So when the two of us do this, that's what you see. One of the things, if you notice, with Dean and Hans, he's got a cigarette in his hand a lot. And sometimes the fingers curl up a little bit. You can't control them sometimes. That's from his fighting days.
Somewhere there's a someone for everyone. Somewhere there's a someone for me. Though I may be only now, I'll see it through somehow. To someone's heart I know I hold a key. Somewhere there's a someone for everyone. Somewhere there's a someone for me. And I'll search my whole life through, until I find the love that's true. For I know somewhere there's a someone for me. Search my whole life through, until I find the love that's true. For I know somewhere there's a someone for me. For I know somewhere there's a someone for me.
Oh, beautiful. Welcome, madame. Welcome, monsieur, to the Faison Bleu restaurant. Oh, may I take your wrap, madame?
I'll give you a wrap. Oh, what is it? Oh.
Right, sir, please. Monsieur, to make yourself comfortable. Yes, a little atmosphere.
Here you are.
Wonderful. What? Let me, sir.
And there you are.
On my back. Okay. And for madame. Whoops, sir. Don't worry, madam. We think of everything. Are you ready? Trust me.
Oh, lay it on, Leon.
Okay, madam.
My goodness, this is certainly an elegant restaurant.
Nothing but the best for you, baby, because tonight I'm going to pop the question.
Excuse me, mademoiselle. Would you like a little something before dinner?
Well, that would be nice.
How about you? You touch me and I'll wrap you right in your head of pasta.
Then, anything you like, sir. Would you like to see a menu?
Good idea.
Menu! First, the wine list. There's some wine, sir.
Could I take this menu home?
Anything you like, sir. Now, do you see something that you like?
Are you putting me on?
Yeah, but I can't put my finger on it. The ribs are very nice and tender today, sir.
Can I pick them up with my hands?
Only if you promise to respect them afterwards.
I'll have the rump roast.
I saw it first. Yep. Pick something else.
Well, then, how about a cold shower?
No, forget it. Forget it. I'll have the chicken.
You'll never be able to finish it all, sir.
Trust me. Trust me.
And for dessert, may I recommend the ladyfingers?
Are they fresh?
Just don't turn your back on them.
Oh, all right. And what is the lady's pleasure?
I'll find out after dinner.
I'll get right on the duck.
Hey there!
One duck, clean and pressed for the lady. No starch, $1.60.
And we'll also have onion soup.
Onion soup.
The tossed salad.
Tossed salad.
Clams at oregano.
And oregano.
And all the white wine.
All the white
wine.
Will
that take long?
I'll do the best I can, sir.
Okay. What kept you?
The chef has a toothache.
Oh, good.
Now for a tossed salad. Here's a salad. Garlic. Rub the bowl with garlic. Okay. One tossed salad. Okay. That's a tossed salad, sir. Everything is fresh. You notice that the hands never leave the body. Okay. Little parsley, sir. Right here. I think you're going to really enjoy this, sir. Here we have. And little parsley. Trust me, madam. Okay. And. Ooh, good luck to you. And here's a tomato.
Oh. Ooh.
Wonderful. Yes, sir. Just hold this for a minute. Okay. You got to be quick. For a little of the dressing right here. Beautiful. And I think you're going to enjoy this part, sir. Here it is. And some music for your listening pleasure. Girl to be your wife?
Well, sure I would.
And you were going to take this man to be your husband?
You bet.
Then by the power vested in me by this restaurant, I now pronounce you man and wife.
Excuse me, have you ever been in Schenectady?
No, I never was in Schenectady.
Neither have I. Must have been a couple other guys. But I still have a feeling I've seen your face someplace else.
No, it's always been right here. Right on the top of my neck. Maybe you've seen me on television.
Oh no, I've never been on television. See, is it all right if I join you? I just dropped in for a little drink to settle my nerves before I go to work.
What sort of work do you do?
I'm an airline pilot.
get to be an airline pilot?
I used to be a bus driver. But I quit. Too many drunks on the road.
What do you fly?
Oh, it's one of those big gray metal things with, what you call it, sticking out on the side.
Wings?
Oh, you an airline pilot too?
I've been pretty high in my time. Did you ever have any close calls as a pilot?
Oh, yes, sir, especially since they moved the men's room to the back of the plane.
I was on a flight from New York to L.A. a couple weeks ago, and the plane lost an engine.
Oh, don't worry, it'll turn up. You know, there's a lot of pressure being a pilot, flying way out there and high in the air and all, above all those white fluffy things.
Clouds?
You sure you're not a pilot? You know, at the same time, it's quite a sobering thought. And a very inspiring feeling to realize that there are hundreds of people on my plane all depending on me. And to that, I happen to hold their lives right in the palm of my hand. Oh, I got it.
Yes?
Yes? I got to get to the airport because I'm flying a 747. I'm flying a 747 to London tonight, and the plane is scheduled to leave precisely 1 hour and 43 minutes ago.
Game time, it's game time. La 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 la. Now we're gonna play a game. La 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 la. You're an old smoothie. Such an old smoothie. La 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 la. You're a big daddy. Such an old.
The Dean Martin Variety Collection is just that. It's a collection of the greatest moments of 10 years of the variety show. 245 variety shows. And I cut them down and presented to this audience some of the great moments with some of the superstars that appeared on these shows. You know, Sinatra, John Wayne, Bob Newhart, every major star that you can think of, Jimmy Stewart. And they all, Orson Welles, everybody blended in as if it were one. Working with Dean. And everybody had a good time. It was a party. It was one hell of a party. And it was worth it, you know. And everybody can relate to Dean. The young people today can relate to Dean because they look at him sitting there with a tuxedo and they go, geez, that's kind of cute, isn't it? Look at that guy, the way he handles that cigarette, the way he smiles, the way he looks at you. I bet he was a nice guy. And I can tell you right now, he was the nicest guy. He was the nicest guy I ever knew. Bar none. No contest. And what you saw was what he was. Cute, nice, charming, decent, and a great performer. the best I ever saw.
Hey, Ernest. You want to help me with the station break announcement?
I choose it. Where's the cue card?
You old cue card person.
Here I am, Mr. Martin.
Ernie, this is our cue card girl, Victoria Hale.
I'm pleased to meet you.
The pleasure is all mine.
Not if I can help it.
Dean, I don't see any cue cards. Where are they?
Well, tell him, honey.
All over my body.
Well, what do you think, Ernie?
Do you remember that picture, Marty, that I was in?
Oh, yes.
Well, there was this scene where my buddy says to me, well, what do you feel like doing tonight, Marty? And I said, I don't know, Ange. What do you feel like doing tonight? And he says, I don't know, Marty. What do you feel like doing? I just figured out what I want to do tonight.
Tell me, miss, do you like being a cue card girl?
Oh, yes. I think it's a wonderful experience.
I can see that success hasn't gone to your head.
A better place.
Dean, isn't it difficult to write on her?
No. The only hard part is getting her in the typewriter.
Oh.
Come on, let's read the announcement.
We'll be right back, folks. So, wait a minute, second. What? Wait a second. I lost my place.
Oh, that's all right. You can take her to my place.
We'll be right back, folks. So don't go away.
Hey, Dean, what are you doing? I got a lip reading. Hey, I got him on right. What are you playing? Hey, I know that one. I know that one.
How I loved the kisses of Dolores till I found out she was Morris.
Tickle on my nose. My buddy Ken here just joined Bachelors Anonymous. It's a great club. Whenever you feel like getting married, you call a member, and he sends over a woman in a torn bathrobe, curlers in her hair, and grease all over her face.
The sweetest sounds I've ever heard are "Have a Drink on Me."
Stick that in. Ken? I guess I'm going to leave you now. Before I go, you think about this. You show me a man who is filthy rich, and I'll show you a wealthy hippie. Come and see in here.
Annie, my baby. I'm so worried about you.
Mama, what's the matter?
Oh, I've been so worried. I was up all night.
Mrs. Lane, why are you worried?
Who are you? Oh, yes, of course. You're that Italian boy, Marvin, who sings on my Kenny show. Kenny, I am so worried about you. Now that you're such a big star, a television show of his own, you'll be meeting a lot of girls, members of the opposite.
Sex?
You're an animal.
What's the matter with the word sex?
Marvin, in front of Kenny, we do not, and I repeat, not use four-letter words like S-E-X. My baby, I've got to tell you the facts of life. I can't put it off any longer.
Why? Did somebody get his teddy bear in trouble? Mrs. Lane, you're going to tell him the facts of life here, right now?
It's better he hears it from me than he picks it up from people who hang around pianos.
Hey, he'll never hear anything from me. I come from a strict home. When all the other kids were playing doctor, I was playing dentist.
Robin, huh? Singers should be seen, not heard. The main thing to remember, dear, is love doesn't have to be cheap or rotten, no. Love can be beautiful, except maybe with your father. See, Kenny, when two people are mutually attracted to each other, there's a whole chemical reaction.
Mrs. Lane.
Oh, not now, Marvin. I'm rolling. Someday you're going to meet a wonderful girl, heaven forbid. And you and that girl are going to want to live together.
Oh, no, Ma. I just got my own room.
Your mother's right, Ken. There's a lot more exciting things in life than sneaking down to the A&P and sniffing cantaloupes.
Don't make sarcastic, Marvin. Remember the old saying, if you break a mother's heart, from this show you can depart. Now, what was it?
facts of life are as follows. A boy and a girl meet. They fall in love. They get married. They leave the church, and that's when it happens.
What's that?
They go to visit his mother. Now, I don't want to be late for my chiropractor's appointment. But before I go, I want you to play that song that I love. And Marvin, cough, baby, if you want, you can sing. But remember that somebody might be listening.
Right. Climb upon my knees, sonny boy.
Does he play beautiful, huh? Believe me, it was worth every penny to have his fingers straightened.
Oh, you're only three, sonny boy.
You think he's good now? Just wait a few years till his feet reach the pedals.
You know we're no one there, no way of showing what you mean to me, sonny boy.
Not too loud, Marvin. Remember, you wouldn't even be on the show if Kenny didn't need a token Italian.
Friends may forsake me.
He looks so nice. It breaks my heart when I think someday his hair is going to turn dark.
Let them all forsake me. I'll still have you, sonny boy.
Never mind the facts of life, Kenny. You should never use your hands for anything but the piano.
Another busy day on Wall Street. Here's a late news item. Underworld kingpin Louis Sinister was released today from the federal penitentiary after he turned state's evidence against the notorious O'Brien gang. Local authorities fear for Sinister's life.
Oh, Solio. Oh, my goodness, look who's here. My favorite customer, Mr. Luigi Sinister. How you doing? Oh, my goodness, you look wonderful. What have you been doing? 6 months? You know, I heard about that. You look all dressed up. Don't tell me you're getting a coming out party, right? Okay, let me have your coat. Here you go. Okay. That's beautiful. Oh, my goodness. Oh, and it's still warm. All right. That's nice. Let me put it over here. Gee whiz. You look very nice. You got a tan. Did they let you walk around in the yard? Here you go. There you are. All right. Here you go. All right. No. Take it easy. It's just a cigarette lighter. Oh, my goodness. You got me all excited. Here you go. Here, just put that away. Come on. Sit down, Mr. Sinister. Right over here. Your favorite chair. Okay. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Here you go. Okay. That's nice. Oh, just relax. And here's your nice paper. What would you like to talk about today, Mr. Sinister? Sports? Politics? Jokes? You want some jokes? All right, that'd be good. Oh, maybe you want to talk about crime does not pay. That's what they think, right? Okay. All right, I'll get you jokes. I'll get you a nice hot towel. You'll relax. Okay.
You.
All right, you kids, get away from here with those firecrackers. Oh, what a noisy neighborhood. Oh, hot towel. Ooh, you took that like a man. That's all right, here, let me get you. Ah, beautiful. That's nice. Boy, that really made you relax fast. Okay, just get your leg up here. Okay, good. Hey, did you see that show Dynasty? You know, I never miss it. I never look at it, so I never miss it. Show that guy Blake Carrington. He's so mean. You look a little like he got a better haircut, though. That's one thing. All right. Did you hear the joke about the guy who came home 2 hours early? He walks in his bedroom, he sees a cigar in the ashtray, he says to his wife, "Where'd the cigar come from?" And from the voice, a closet says, and from the closet, a voice says, Havana. Hey, let me sit you up, Mr. S. Okay, here you go. All right, beautiful. Easy does it. Okay. Boy, you really must have had a late night last night. Okay. Oh, yesterday it was so cold. I saw a congressman with his hands in his own pocket. That's it. Sit up. Okay. There you go. Let me get your arm down here. Okay. Let me swing this chair over here a little bit. Okay, that's good. All right. Hey, what do you get? What do you get when you cross? Let me get this air over here. What do you get when you cross an owl and a goat? A hoom nanny. No good. All right. A man goes to the moon. He sees a 12-foot gorgeous lady. He walks up to her and he says, "Take me to your ladder. I'll see your leader later." Okay. Now, a drunk puts a dime in a meter. It goes to 60. The drunk says, "Oh, my goodness, I lost 100 pounds. Oh, you like that one. Wait a minute. Okay. Let me sit you up here again. Okay. Good. A man has a new Mercedes, and he's driving it. He wraps it around a pole. A policeman comes along and says, "That's how the Mercedes bends." Here, sit up a minute, Mr. Martin. You're gonna miss this. A guy's in his backyard. He's cooking a chicken on the rotisserie. Oh, solo mio. A drunk walks by. He looks at him and he says, "You got a lovely voice, but I think your monkey's on fire." Doctor says to this woman, "You're going to have an operation." The woman says, "Wait a minute. I want a second opinion." The doctor says, "Okay, you're also very ugly." Let me get this hair in your ear. You're all done. Oh, my goodness. I'll call your mother. Oh, my goodness.
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for a laugh transplant. Here's one of the funniest guys I know, Mr. Bob Newhart.
Thank you. As more and more high-rise buildings go up in our cities, there's a proportionate increase in the number of people who jump off of these buildings, and it's becoming quite a problem, but psychologists tell us that there is a definite way of handling it. The main thing is to never issue any direct commands or to try to talk the person out of it, and perhaps the most important is to be very, very casual. Now, I would like to show you a psychologist who's been called to deal with a man on the ledge. I think he would probably light up a cigarette and handle it something like this.
Oh, hi there.
You bet your cheeks is high.
You're thinking about jumping, are you?
It's the only way out.
This is your first time?
You ain't gonna try and stop me, are you?
No. I'm on my way to work. Matter of fact, I usually walk around the buildings. You know, it kind of helps me unwind, you know? You don't happen to be in advertising by any chance, do you?
Yeah, I am masterminded a campaign for Harold Stassen.
How did you know? Well, it's more than a lucky guess. We get an awful lot of advertising people out here. The reason I asked, there are some advertising guys on the southeast corner. I thought maybe you might know them. I didn't get their names. One guy had the Edsel account. I remember that. You know you're drawing a hell of a crowd for a weekday, you know that? Yeah, jumping has really fallen off the last... No pun intended, you know. No, seriously, you take, 1929. You literally couldn't get out on this ledge in 1929. you see that cart down there?
Hmm? Where?
Yeah, that's it, down there, the cart. That's Sam, the hot dog man. Mm-hmm. Hi, Sam, how are you? I was just telling him, hello, crowd for a Thursday, isn't it? have you eaten, by the way?
Well, I'd hate to eat and run.
Listen, two, Sam. You like everything on me? Yeah, two with everything, Sam. No, make one to go, Sam, would you?
Hey, who are those guys down there with the net?
Uh-oh, I think something turned you in. Those are firemen.
I don't care who they are. They're in my way.
I get... I give you a little tip there. You might kind of edge your way to the corner of the building, you know. Then they start to follow you. Then you run back here and jump. they get all confused, you know. They pull on the net. They'll never make it back in time.
Well, I hope they fall for it.
Fall for it. Oh, that's beautiful. Listen, I really ought to be going, you know. Listen, I'd love to stay and catch you. But I got a hot dog waiting down. Well, I'll be rooting for you. Listen, I tell you what, if you're not in much of a hurry, why don't the both of us go down and we'll get our hot dog and we'll talk it over, huh?
Yeah, well, maybe you're right. Let's go down.
Fine. I'll go through the window and help you through, huh? One.
You know, in every marriage, there's always little chores that a wife doesn't particularly like to do. Sometimes it's cooking, sometimes it's cleaning, and in some marriages, the wives are just not affectionate. Ah, but here's an enterprising wife who hired somebody to perform this little chore for her.
Yvette, I think I hear my husband coming home. Would you answer the door? Hello, darling.
Hello, gosh, you look pretty tonight, sweetheart. That's all right.
You certainly have come home in a good mood, but, darling, you look exhausted. Oh. Why don't you come over here and sit down?
Okay, sweetheart.
Oh, well, I can't tell you how good it feels to be home.
You notice anything different about me, darling?
What do you mean?
My perfume.
I'll say.
Stop it, Roger. Oh, where are they? Roger, stop it. You'll wake the children.
So what? They know we're married.
You know, Roger, I'm the luckiest woman in the world being married to you. And this may surprise you, but you know, some of my girlfriend's husbands actually fool around on the outside.
Well, not me. I got everything I want at home.
I'll never forget our wedding night.
Neither will I.
Neither will I. I was so happy and relaxed, I slept like a baby.
That's funny. I didn't sleep at all. Darling, what do you say we skip dinner and turn in early tonight?
Good idea.
Yeah.
And they say you can't get good help these days.
Pleasure having you on my show.
Oh, the pleasure's mine, Dean. You've always been my favorite singer. Hmm? In fact, when I was a child, my mother used your records to put me to sleep.
Really?
Yeah, she used to hit me over the head with them. No kidding, Dean. You're my idol. I worship the ground you crawl on. So enamored am I of your many talents that I've compiled a series of slides depicting the highlights of your career.
Yeah, I'd like to see them sometime.
Well, grab some popcorn and sit down. Now watch the screen up there. Because here comes the first slide. Lights out, please. Now, here you are, Dean, just starting out in show business. And there's the elephant trainer handing you the shovel. And there's the first room you ever played in. And that's a husband chasing out the window. Here's your first exposure on national television. And here's Ed Sullivan making you put your clothes back on. Now, here you are making a record with a girl singer. Here's Frank Sinatra with the same girl breaking a record. How'd that one get in there? And here you are smashing Frank's patrol in retaliation.
Hey, what's that blank slide up there for?
Well, it's intermission. I thought you might want to go to powder room.
Never mind. I'll wait till after the cartoon.
So be it. Act two. Now, right here is here's a group of female admirers screaming while you sing. Now, here you are closing the shower curtain. Here's a memorable shot of you shaking hands with the queen. Now, here you are shaking hands with his roommate. Hey! And finally, as a fitting climax to your industrious career, here's the mayor of your hometown, Steubenville, Ohio, giving you the key to the city. And, of course, you know what that is.
Yeah, that's all the women in Steubenville changing their locks.
Well, it was a good funeral.
Good funeral.
We gave him a good send-off.
No man could want more. He was a good man, George. We won't see his like again. Salt of the earth, he was.
He was salt of the earth. Still, he had a good run.
A good run.
Funny, he never married.
Who?
George.
Oh, him. It's funny he never married. Not that he never had the chance. When he was young, I mean, he was good-looking enough. Almost too good-looking.
He could have any girl he wanted.
Any girl he wanted.
With that blonde hair of his.
Oh, yes.
Those big blue eyes.
Yeah.
And those dimples.
Those dimples.
Any girl he chose.
Yeah.
Funny he never married. He had compensations, though.
Compensation.
Other interests. Scouting.
He was very keen on scouting.
Oh, very keen.
Oh, yes. He liked scouting even in his later years. He'd only have to see a troop of scouts go by and his eyes would light up. Nostalgia, I suppose. Funny he never married.
Funny.
He was a funny man in many ways. Where he walked. That was funny.
His hips.
Oh, that was funny. And his voice.
High-pitched.
Almost to a point of a falsetto. Love flowers, he did. Oh, always smelled of lily of the valley. Funny man in many ways.
Yes. Always lily of the valley. Always.
All gardenias on special occasions. This is funny man in many ways.
Funny, yes.
But kind.
Kind, very kind.
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 Almost too kind.
Yes.
Yes, he let himself be taken advantage of. He could never turn anybody away from his door.
It was always a bed for any waif, stray, soldier, sailor.
Especially sailors. He got on with sailors. I never knew him to turn a sailor away. The fact that he didn't have to come to him, he'd go looking for them. Never spared himself.
Funny, he never married. He'd have made a good husband.
Oh, he would. There's no denying that. He's a very good husband, he'd have made, yeah. He could cook.
Knit.
So, his house was always clean as a whistle.
Clean as a whistle.
Clean, clean.
Whistle. He was a happy man, though.
Oh, yes, he was happy enough.
And he was never happier than when he was dressing up.
True.
Do you remember how he loved his mother-of-pearl purse?
And how sad he was when he lost it on the all-night bus.
Never happier than when he was dressing up.
Oh, never.
Theatrical streak, I suppose.
I suppose.
All in all, he was funny. You know, it's funny he never married.
Funny.
What?
You never married.
Don't know why there's no sun up in the sky, stormy weather, since my gal and I ain't together. Keeps raining all the time. Life is bare. Gloom and misery everywhere.
I can't help it. This guy's the funniest guy in the world. Everything he says is good.
Stormy weather.
See what I mean?
Just can't get my poor self together.
You just made that up. Did you just make that up?
I'm weary all the time.
Will you hear this?
The time. Weary all the time.
No matter how many times you said it's still funny.
When you went away, the blues walked in and met me.
The blues walked in and met me. Could you just die?
If
she stays in the old rocking chair. Gonna get
me. And you thought the other guy was the funny one?
The Lord is God, let me.
Tell the boy about walking in the sun.
Walking in the sun. Can't go on.
I can't go on.
Everything I have is gone.
Here he comes again.
Stormy wind. If I get an eye to get through.
I can't. I don't know what he gets it for.
In it all.
What the heck are you laughing at?
Try and cheer up, will you? Joey Payne, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, yes, madam. Your tickets will be at the box office. Yes, that's 8 o'clock curtain. Yes, I'm sure you'll enjoy the play so much. Thank you so much for calling. Bye-bye. A good day, sir. May I help you, please?
Yes, do you have any plays with elephants in them?
I beg your pardon, sir.
Do you have any plays with elephants in them?
I don't seem to follow you, sir.
Well, I want to see a play with an elephant in it.
With an elephant in it?
Yes.
I'm sorry, there is not a play at this time on the West End playing with an elephant in it. I'm terribly sorry, but thank you so much for coming.
Of course, I had my heart set on elephants, you see.
Oh, why don't you go to the circus?
Oh, are there elephants in there?
Oh, yes, there's lots of elephants and seals.
I don't like seals. I've never been with elephants and without seals.
What was that again? You want with elephants and without seals? Well, I don't think so. I'm positive, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming.
What about that?
Oh, that's Hamlet, sir.
Are there any elephants in that?
Frankly, not all that many. You see, Shakespeare was rather frugal with his use of elephants in his play. And to be perfectly honest with you, sir, I do not think there is one. I must honestly admit there is not one at all in Hamlet. There are no elephants. Thank you so much.
No
trouble, sir. Thank you. Come again.
I'll call back after lunch to see if anything with elephants has cropped up in the interim.
Yes, lovely. You do that. Thank you, sir.
Oh, while I'm here, do you have any plays with nudist ice skaters or naked ladies playing football?
With what, sir?
Naked ladies playing football.
No, I'm terribly sorry. We don't.
Are you sure?
I'm positive, sir.
Well, what about this play where this woman loves this man, and after many trials and tribulations, they go off together on an elephant?
Yes! No! Look, I have a perfect play for you. Why don't you try and visit Agatha Christie's great, great thriller, The Mousetrap? It's very popular with people of your type.
I don't like mice.
But there's no mouse in The Mousetrap.
Hey, that's where you're going, is there?
No, you see, but it's very exciting. You see, there's this whole group of people, and one of them is mysteriously murdered.
By an elephant?
By an elephant, yes.
And are there clowns in it?
Oh, yes, there's lots of clowns.
I don't like clowns.
Oh, no. Well, there's no clowns in it at all. See, no clowns at all, sir.
Well, what are they then?
What do you like, sir?
Naked ladies playing football.
Yes. Look, there's lots of naked ladies playing football. In fact, so the plot involves a group of naked ladies playing football on the lawn, and one of them is mysteriously murdered by the elephant.
Are there midgets involved?
Oh, yes, there's a midget. There's a midget.
Police inspector?
Yes, you know it. There is a midget police inspector, and this midget police inspector, he enters.
Playing the banjo?
Yes, brilliant playing the banjo. Brilliant banjo playing midget policeman enters, and he gathers all the suspects into the library, sir.
Who are they?
Well, there's a...
Who do you want? Douglas?
Oh, there's lots of Douglas. See the Douglas?
Donald Duck.
Donald Duck is there, yes.
Lou Grade in the News.
Oh! Yes, Lou Grade in the New Year's in there.
Margaret Rutherford on ice skate.
Yes, Margaret Rutherford on ice skate.
The Queen
is there, yes, sir. Yes,
sir.
No, there's no seal. Sir, listen, just between you and me, the seal establishes alibi early in the first act, and he got to go home.
And where does Engelbert come from?
Who are they?
Engelbert.
Engelbert. Oh, they're there. Yes, they're all there.
Yes. And who did it?
The elephant?
Oh, no.
No.
He was merely shielding.
Oh, yes, and the midget banjo, brilliant banjo playing inspector, he reveals the real killer in the library.
Engelbert Humperdinck.
Yes, it is Engelbert Humperdinck. Here is your ticket. The curtain falls. Everyone loves the play. It's 30 shillings. Please, no, you don't even have to pay, sir. You may keep the ticket. You may go to the theater.
Yes, wait.
Oh, no. Play.
With giraffes.
Oh, with giraffes?
Giraffes.
Oh, yes, there's several giraffes in Othello.
Othello.
Oh, you love that. There are midgets and there's banjo playing.
Every day is Ladies' Day with me. I'm
wife at their disposal all the while. And my pleasure it is double if they come to me in trouble, for I always find a way to make them smile, the little darlings. I've no doubt I should have married long ago. Here's the proper thing to do, you'll all agree. But I never could find any fun in wasting all my time on her. Every day is ladies' day with me.
Lost on the ground, you in mid-air, send in the clowns. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? One who keeps moving around, one who can't move. Where are the clowns? Send in the clowns. Just when I stopped opening doors, finally knowing the one that I wanted was yours, making my entrance again with my usual flair, sure of my lines, no one is there. Don't you love a farce? My fault, I fear. I thought that you'd want what I want. Sorry, my dear. Where are the clowns? Send in the clowns. Don't bother, they're here. Isn't it rich? Isn't it queer? Losing my timing this late in my career. Where are the clowns? There ought to be clowns. Well, maybe next year.
Where are the clowns? They aren't around anymore. Neither is their spirit. They're beautiful, exuberant, childlike zaniness. They flourished, of course, in the old variety shows. Are they gone forever, the clowns? Or were they, after all, the product of a different time, another generation? Is it too difficult to clown about minority rights, free love, political corruption, and such like themes for modern comedy? Personally, if I had the choice, I'd go for the clowns, wouldn't you?
Well, maybe next year.